YouTube, what is up? Back with another video. This is the third video in a short series. This is the Super Bowl matchup prediction. Gotta warn you before you watch this video and continue. If you haven't already, I would like you to go watch these two videos first, my AFC and NFC predictions on who is going to win every game, every wildcard game, divisional, and the AFC and NFC championship game. I don't want to spoil my playoff bracket. If you haven't watched those videos, so please go watch them right now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, what is up, YouTube? Back with the Super Bowl prediction video. As you can see on your screen right here, here are my two brackets combined. We have the Green Bay Packers playing the Buffalo Bills in Super Bowl 55. As you can see, the Buffalo Bills make the Super Bowl after steamrolling the Ravens and the Steelers and the Colts. They don't have to beat the Chiefs because the Ravens will take care of that. And the Green Bay Packers, their number one seed, home field advantage, so critical. Teams do not beat the Packers at home. It is going to be difficult, and the Packers have won all those games. The Saints, the Buccaneers, it's going to be a Super Bowl run for both these teams. Which team is going to come off on top? So if this is the outcome, here are the things that I would like to look at if these two teams play in the Super Bowl. It's definitely going to be a battle of the most elite offenses. Obviously, both these teams have, I think, the top three quarterbacks in the league. We got, of course, Aaron Rodgers, Mahomes at one probably, and Josh Allen at three. These three quarterbacks have been lighting it up with statistics. Aaron Rodgers has, I believe, the most touchdown passes. Josh Allen, I think he has the most passing yards along with Mahomes, something like that. But both of these quarterbacks have very similar and elite offensive stats. This is definitely going to be an offensive game. Both these teams have star wide receivers, both at their position. Davante Adams, absolutely lighting it up. I believe he had the most touchdown receptions on the year. And then on the Bills side, we got Stephon Diggs. Look at that. Stephon Diggs had the most receiving yards and receptions in the NFL this season. Absolute monster. Josh Allen just flipped the script from 2019. The Bills were a really defensive team, and now it's all Josh Allen and Stephon Diggs just absolutely lighting it up. So in that aspect, both these teams are very similar. They rely on the quarterback to wide receiver duo. Like, literally, it's the same exact thing. I would say the Packers are in a more established rushing offense with Aaron Jones. The Bills, they don't really even need to run the ball, because Josh Allen to the receivers, Stephon Diggs, Cole Beasley, John Brown, Dawson Knox at tight end, that, you know, connection is basically unstoppable, only because the Bills' offensive line is so good that Josh Allen has literally 20 minutes to decide where he wants to throw the ball. And if he can't throw the ball, if he doesn't have any open targets, this dude is mobile, he's fast, he's strong, he will run for the first down. So that's why, you know, the passing game for the Bills is so elite. They don't even need to run the ball because defenses can't stop it. We look at the Packers, they're very similar. They run the ball effectively though, not like the Bills. The Bills can run the ball, but it's not as effective as the Packers. But besides that, Aaron Rodgers would rather throw a one-yard touchdown pass to Davante Adams, Robert Tonyan, then run the ball on the goal line. I've seen that many times this season. So these teams are very similar in that aspect of the game. If you were to ask me which team has a better offense, I honestly can't give you a good answer, because they're good in different ways. The Bills will absolutely torch you by passing the ball. They'll torch every team in the league. And Aaron Rodgers will torch you. He has the most touchdowns in the NFL this season, so it's really unclear to say which is better. But I would say the Bills' passing game is better than the Packers' passing game. And the Packers' rushing game is obviously better than the Bills' rushing game. The Bills' passing game isn't that much better, but it definitely is better. So offense, which offense would I rather have? It doesn't really matter. At this point in time, I think I'd rather have the Bills' offense. I think it's playing better than every offense in the NFL. but it's literally the same thing as the Packers. It's going to be that kind of game. So now we got to look at the defenses. So let's start off by which team seems to have the better defensive line. So I want to start off with sacks. Which team gets more sacks? Obviously, the Packers have more sacks than the Bills this season because of Za'Darius Smith with 12 and a half sacks on the season, fifth in the NFL. We compare that to Buffalo's sack leader. It's not even comparable. It's very low on the list. So obviously, if you're looking for a sack, Za'Darius Smith is going to have a big game. Or is he? Because the problem with that is that the Bills' offensive line is so elite, it doesn't allow Josh Allen to get sacked. Even if you get to the quarterback, Josh Allen is very mobile. He's very fast. He can escape. He'll either run to the left, run to the right, and look for a receiver to throw the football to, which is really scary if you're a defense. And if no receiver's open, the dude runs down the field, gets yardage, and potentially gets the first down. So I'm honestly not expecting Josh Allen to get sacked a lot in this game. I can see one or two. If you're looking for your team to get a turnover, don't hope for it. Both of these passers are very accurate. They don't turn the ball over. And both of these defenses aren't really that special in that type of way, turning the ball over. Getting interceptions, forcing fumbles, it's not really, a key factor when it comes to both these defenses. And specifically both these offenses, like I just said, Aaron Rodgers rarely throws interceptions. Josh Allen has been also very, very clean this year at not throwing picks and throwing more touchdowns. So don't look for turnovers in this game. Like I said, this is strictly just going to be an offensive matchup. Both these defenses are ranked very close to each other. They're not special and they're not bad. These defenses won't win you games. They won't turn the ball over. And they're also not going to lose you games. But that could be a different scenario here. Both these defenses have the opportunity to, stop a good team, a good offense from scoring. But these teams are different. Both these teams are very special on offense. Defense is not going to play a factor in this game. It's really just going to come down to which offense plays better. And honestly, I have no idea. If I were to pick a defense, though, honestly, you look at the start of the season, the Bills and the Packers both had pretty weak starts. I mean, I guess you can say that. But as the season continues, their defenses get better and better and better. But, it's not special. They've just been getting better. I'd rank both these teams in the middle of the league defensively, and that's not really why they're good. But if I were to pick a defense, honestly, I don't even know. Probably the Packers, they clutch up. Maybe the Bills, they clutch up. They have very talented players like Tremaine Edmonds, Tre'Davious White. Some players are good. Some players aren't. Doesn't really matter. Pick your poison. All that matters is which team has the better offense. And honestly, these teams are very, very, very similar. Like defensively and offensively, they're basically the same thing. So with all this being said, this brings us to the final question. Which team is going to win the Super Bowl? The answer to your question is the team that performs better on offense. Like I said, defense, they're going to play decently on both sides of the football. Probably going to get some stops here and there. So whichever offense plays better wins the game. And pick your poison. Like I said, Aaron Rodgers, he will destroy everyone. The Bills, they can destroy you too. I think if you're in this matchup, and if you're rooting for your team to win, this is what your team should do. They should either run the ball a lot and get first downs effectively and throw the ball for short passes, stay in bounds, and run the clock. If you run the clock, you'll have more time on the field and you'll make the defense more tired and more tired. You'll have the other team's offense on the bench just sitting there doing nothing. If you run down the clock, your offense will make this defense so tired that you'll basically be able to score for the rest of the game if you continue to do that strategy. And honestly, I think that's the way to go. Which team is good at this? Both these teams are really good at this. So it really could come down to which team scores a touchdown first to set the tone of the game. And I don't know who's going to. It's going to be 50-50. But if I were to pick a team to win this game, honestly, I'm going with the Buffalo Bills to win the Super Bowl. These teams are both electric, and I think the Buffalo Bills have the ability to run the clock down really quickly. I watched this against the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Pittsburgh Steelers had a chance to come back in the third and fourth quarter after scoring, but the Buffalo Bills just destroyed the clock. I believe they had a 6 to 8 minute drive in the fourth quarter, ruining the chances of the other offense. Since the Green Bay defense isn't, you know, the best, you know, the Buffalo Bills have the opportunity to do this. I believe they will do this if they have a lead in the second half, especially in the fourth quarter. I believe that's a really high possibility, and that's why I'm picking the Bills to win the Super Bowl. Definitely one of the better Super Bowls in a long time. You know, no more Patriots, no more, you know, horrible NFC teams. A solid offensive matchup. It's going to be good. That is it. So comment down your Super Bowl predictions. Who you think would win this game specifically? Thanks for watching. Adios.